Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Watch this. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. I'm going to show you. In this Bible, ain't nobody ever broke this Bible down to us correct to where we can understand our nationality in it. That's why it's important for us to be out here to teach our people. And with y'all coming up and y'all coming up and y'all young, now y'all get this information while you're young. And when you're an adult, ain't nobody going to be able to deceive you. Because watch this. Brother, do you know your nationality? Huh? See, that's the problem, right? This is a grown man that probably don't know his nationality. So now what we gonna do, we's gonna break the cycle. Give me that, Deuteronomy 101.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
So Moses is speaking to who? All Israel, right? Right? It said, these be the words which Moses spoke to all Israel. So they came up out of Egypt. Now Moses is in the wilderness speaking to the Israelites. This is what he told the Israelites. Verse 15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So it says, Moses said, listen, you Israelites, if y'all don't listen to what God is saying to do what?
Hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day.
He said that if y'all don't listen to what God say do and do his commandments, read.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. So let me ask you this. Is a curse a good thing or a bad thing? It's a bad thing, right? Is it safe to say that the conditions that we living in is a curse? Is it safe to say that? Sister, let me ask you something. Is it safe to say that the conditions that we living in 2020 in Tulsa, Oklahoma, does that seem like a curse to you? But is everybody in the same predicament though? No? Who else is in this predicament that's not in this predicament that we in? White people? You said white people? Hispanics? Hispanics don't go through the same stuff we go through? Oh, they do. So it's kind of like a coalition in with the stuff that we got going on with ourselves and the Hispanics. It's kind of like we hand to hand, right? And then the white folks, they don't live in these conditions, right? Why? They're not the same as us. You're absolutely 100% correct. God chose us over everybody else on the face of this earth. And the reason why we don't know that is because they're not teaching this. The pastors ain't teaching this. They're not teaching this in the school. And if you really look at it, the ones that's ruling over all of these the schools, the churches and all that is who? Who runs that? So why would they tell us, oh, God chose y'all? Why would the white people tell us that Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6? Read that. Watch this. Watch what the Bible say. Watch what God say about us.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So, sister, if God is saying that you are a special people to himself, that means that you are chosen by God, right? And if it says that you are above all people on the face of this earth, are we equal? Are we all created equal? We are. If the Bible says that you are above all people that are on the face of the earth, you Israelites are above all people on the face of this earth, that makes us equal? Right. So why is it that we sitting up and we trying to march for equality? How come is it every time an injustice come, we want to go march and have these same people that's putting this injustice on us, with us, amongst us, trying to march? This Bible is written to the Israelites, by the Israelites, and for the Israelites. Right. It's only one God, and that's the God of the Israelites, the so-called Black, Hispanics, and Natives. Give me that in Joel chapter 2 and verse 27. Because a lot of people like to think that, oh no, God loves everybody. But we just read that God chose the Israelites, correct? That should make you feel special. You know what I'm saying? Because here it is, the Most High God said, what's your name again? Lamaya, and yours? Stephanie, and yours? Miracle said, listen, y'all, I choose y'all over everybody else. I'm not choosing nobody else. I'm dealing with y'all. Y'all are the Israelites. This is what the Bible is saying. Watch this.
Joel chapter 2 and verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
Of who?
Of Israel.
Of the blacks.
Of Israel.
Of the African Americans.
Of Israel. Uh-huh. And that I am the Lord, your God, and none else.
You see that? It's only one God, and that's our God. So when you going around and you see this man over here, who is that? Who's this man over here? This man over here. Grab that sign for me. Is a sign down there? Oh, you can't pick it up. Come over here. Come look at this sign. You good. Come look at this sign. Who is this man right here? Y'all never seen him before? This dude right here. Y'all ain't never seen this dude right here? Who is that? I bet you she know. Who is this right here, ma'am? You got no clue who this is? This man? Oh yeah, supposed to be Jesus. How come is it that everybody and their mama sees this and thinks that that's Jesus, but the Bible doesn't say nothing about him looking like that?
That's right.
Huh? Because it's taught, right? That's the importance of us to come out here and cast down those imaginations. That's why it's important for us to be out here to teach y'all so y'all can understand. So I'm going to go into that and show y'all who that is. But first, I want to go back to show y'all about these curses that we was talking about, so you can first identify yourself with being an Israelite. So go back to 28 verse 15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the scripture said that when you don't listen to God, you will be a cursed people, right? So now we're finna go over some curses, and I want to see who do these curses identify with. Give me verse 16.
Verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field.
So this is, what city we in? Tulsa? This is Tulsa, right? Have y'all lived anywhere else in y'all life? Only Tulsa, right? Well, I done travel, right? And I done lived different places. I'm actually from Los Angeles. I lived in Las Vegas. These are different cities that I've been to. And every city that I go to, I see us, the ones living in the conditions that we living in. I see us, the ones that's living at the bottom of society. I see us, the ones that's on welfare, gotta catch the bus,
right,
gotta get the worst jobs.
Right.
That's being cursed in the city. Every city you go to, you will find the Israelites on the bottom of society. So that's one way that you can identify who the Israelites are. And it said cursed in the fields. So let's do a little history challenge real quick. During history, when was our people cursed in the fields? Slavery, right? Who had to pick the cotton? Who had to pick the tobacco? Who was at the ones in there sweating and getting bloody and getting beat bloody? Yeah, where's the signs at? Who was that? That happened to us. That was us, the ones that was going through that. That's us being cursed in the field. Every city that we go to, we at the bottom of society.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.